cities look pretty formidable. And so they came back from their tour of the promised land that God had promised to them with all these fears and anxieties. I'm going to say something to you. It's very important. Listen to this. Every time you take your eyes off of God and you begin looking at problems and thinking about all the obstacles and problems that are in your way, you will start getting so fearful and anxious that you're not willing to follow God anymore or trust God anymore, because you start seeing all these problems and then you want to reason and talk about it and argue and debate about everything, about, well, who's going to do this and who's going to do that? And what if this happens and what if that happens? And I want to say, you think that God didn't already anticipate everything you're ever going to face? Everything that you and I will ever face, every obstacle, every problem, every sickness, every time we lose our job, every time whatever happens, somebody gets in our way, God already knew about it. Before you face it, He already knew about it. I'm going to say, get over that. Stop thinking about all what can go wrong and start thinking about what is great about Almighty God. And He, if you follow Him, you don't have to worry about where He leads you. He's already got it. He's prayer shelves got Hebrew written on it. And I've got Christian scriptures on the corners of it. So because I'm a Christian, I'm one of the Christian prayer shawl. So I have a prayer shawl. And when you wear a prayer shawl, there's some unique things about wearing a prayer shawl. When they were in the desert, we talk about going and praying in your closet. How many closets are there in a tent? No closet. So how do you get a private place, a quiet place, when you're in the desert? You put on a prayer shawl and you cover up. This is the closet. And you get in your closet. And you can pray inside of it because it keeps you from being distracted by all the stuff we see around us. Another thing about a prayer shawl is it has these, Hebrew word is tzitzit. It's these little tassels that are on the, tassels is probably an English corruption of the word, but it's tzitzit, and it's these little fringes, that's the fringes we're talking about. And it has blue and it has white thread. And there's certain kinds of knots. And a young man, when he reaches his age of adulthood, is supposed to tie his own knots. The reason is the knots represent the commandments of God. When you wear your prayer shawl, it reminds you of a number of things. One, it reminds you who you are. A person that God chose. You're a person that God chose. In our case, as a Christian, we know that He gave His Son to die for us. So when I put on a prayer shawl, and you may put on a cross, you might put on a fish, you might put on some kind of Christian jewelry, and the Christian jewelry should remind you who you are, which is a Christian, a child of God, bought with a price. So when you put on a prayer shawl, it reminded the Jewish people that they were the didn't deserve it, but they were chosen to be the people of God. So they were the people of God. So they put this on with the tassels in the corner, and those were to remind them of the commandments of God. And if you remember who you are, shouldn't you act like who you are? If a girl feels like she's a princess, a child, a princess of God, a one chosen by God, set apart by God for God's purpose, holy purpose, that girl should remember she is a person that God loves and has a special purpose for her. And she should and probably will act like who she believes she is. Same for a young man. He's going to act like who he believes he is. If people have a very poor image of themselves and don't think much of who they are, the tragedy is they act like that. They feel like they're not worth anything. Amen. So I'm not talking about having any pride. I'm not talking about it because if you have a humility before God, brokenness before God. But if we are God's and He paid for us, then we need to act like we are who we are, right? And so that's why they wear the prayer shawl. That's why the fringes. Jesus talked to them and he warned the religious leaders. He said, you enlarge the borders of your garments. Here's the danger, pride. They would make big tassels with great big knots on the corners of the prayer shawl. Why would they do that? I am so holy. I got bigger tassels than you got. And Jesus looked at that and it offended him because he said, this is between you and God. This is your reminder. This is not for everybody else to be impressed. So when we talk about this, the fringe is talking about remembering who you are and what the commandments of God are, and you're accountable to God for your actions and your behavior, your attitude. Okay? 3,550 men of war, 603,550 men of war came out of Egypt, and only two men entered the promised land. All the rest of them reasoned among themselves, sent out the spies, listened to the majority. By the way, I believe this is what's dangerous to have a majority vote. I say, and I'll tell you a secret, I have one question. What is his will? What people vote for or don't vote for, I want to know. What is God's will about everything? If it's no, the answer is no. If it's yes, the answer is yes. That's just where I'm at. Okay? Caleb had faith in Almighty God, and that enabled him to have a promise to go in and inherit the land. And in fact, when he came in, this guy was amazing. He was 85 years old. Give me that mountain. He had not lost his faith in God. He was still strong to go out and come in. He was still a mighty warrior, and he was an old man, really. But he had faith in God. God enabled him to do great things, and he got blessed. And his own descendants inherited this land around the city called Hebron. Still there today, by the way. And the Palestinians are mainly the ones that run that city in Israel. Jeremiah 29:13 says, and ye shall seek me and find me when ye search for me with all your heart. Because somebody's got to say to me, if you're really thinking and following me, you got to be saying, how can I follow him if I don't know him? And that's a really good question. That's a good question, because if you don't know him, how in the world do you know who to follow? Right? God knows who to follow. Well, the day that you, it says, the day and you shall seek me and find me when you search me with all your heart. What are you holding back? What are you holding back? He said, follow me with all your heart. I can't answer that question for you. You need to talk to God and ask the question, what is it that I'm holding back from God? John 14:21 says, he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. And I will love him, and I will manifest myself to him. When you know and you're reminded of what God's told you to do, one simple one is to love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. That covers the whole law of God. Covers the whole law. Because if you love God, you're going to honor your father and mother. If you love God, you won't murder anybody. If you love God, you're not going to steal from anybody. If you love God, you're not going to, and you love your neighbor, you're not going to bear a false witness against them. If you love God, you're not going to desire to have what somebody else has received from God. You'd be content with whatever God blesses. If he blesses you, I'd say, praise God, he blessed you.